In this illustration, we'll discuss about the depression in a horizontally stretched wire. We are given that a steel wire of original length 1 meter and cross-sectional area 4 mm square is clamped at the two ends so that it lies horizontally and without tension. And further it is saying, if a load of 2.16 kg is suspended from the middle point of wire, we are required to find what would be its vertical depression. The Young modulus and G is also given to us. Here in solution, first we can draw the figure between two ends. A wire is stretched and the wire is of length 1 meter, which is given to us. And at the middle one, a load is hanged, then the wire will get depressed at the middle point. And see, the load is of weight 2.16 g. And if in the wires, the tension T is developed over here. And if this angle is theta, here we can write the upward force on the junction due to these two tensions is 2t sine theta. And if it is depressed by a distance x vertically down the midpoint, then we can write for equilibrium, of a block, which is the load in the given case, here we use 2t sine theta is equals to mg, and mass is 2.16 g, we can take as 10, so this is 21.6 newton. And this gives us the value of tension, that is equals to 21.6 by 2 is 10.8 divided by sine theta. And here the value of sine theta we can approximately write as 10 theta, which is x divided by 0.5. So we substitute the value of sine theta here. This 10.8 multiplied by 0.5 is 5.4 divided by x. This is the value of tension in the string we are getting. And if we calculate the strain in one half of wire is, here we can calculate the strain as delta L by L, that is equals to the length after elongation of this wire minus initial elongation, we can write it root of x square plus 0.5 square minus 0.5 divided by 0.5. This is the strain in this left half of wire, which on simplifying we can write this root of 1 plus x by 0.5 whole square minus 1, in which we can apply binomial approximation as x is very small. This can be written as 1 plus half of x square by 0.5 whole square minus 1. And here this 1 gets cancelled out and we are getting the strain to be equals to x square by 2 multiplied by 0.25, so this x square by 0.5. As we have got the strain, we can write down the Young's modulus of wire. This can be given as stress by strain. So in this situation, a stress is the tension divided by area. We are already provided with the cross-sectional area of wire, which is 4 mm square. So we can write that T is, we already calculated the tension as 5.4 divided by x, divided by the area, which is 4 multiplied by 10 to power minus 6, divided by strain, we are having a x square by 0.5. If we substitute the value of Young modulus, here You can see this will give us 2 into 10 to power 11 is equals to, simplifying these terms, we are getting the numerical value to be 2.7. This is 5.4 by 4 multiplied by 0.5. So this will give 2.7 divided by 4 into 10 to power minus 6 times x cube, which gives us the value of x cube is equal to this 2.7 upon 8 into 10 to power 5. And the numerical value is 3.375 into 10 to power minus 6. And on taking cube root of this numerical value, we'll get x as 1.5 into 10 to power minus 2 meter, or it is 1.5 centimeter. That is the result of this problem.